In this video, you'll be learning about this topic.
So, Samson, one of the things that I think a lot of people in the Bitcoin community might not know about you is that you do a lot of product for gaming and software for gaming industry. And you have a team, and that team of people that you currently have, they've worked on projects that have generated over $1 billion in revenue in the gaming industry. And you guys are getting ready to release a new game. But what I find fascinating is you're leveraging all the tech that we just talked about on this entire episode with utility tokens, security tokens, the game itself, it's intertwined. Talk to us about what's going on here and just educate us. This sounds fascinating.
So the game we're working on is called Infinite Fleet. It's an MMO strategy game. And for those that don't know, MMO stands for Massively Multiplayer Online Game. So these are games like World of Warcraft, EVE Online. They have a 10 to 20 year shelf life. And you know, at their peak, they can generate hundreds of millions of dollars in revenue per year. And the development team we have behind this game is amazing. We've got top tier AAA talent. I personally have worked on Company of Heroes, Dawn of War. A lot of our other developers have worked on top titles for Sega, Nintendo, EA. And we've actually got one of the developers from Ultima Online, the original MMO game. This is like a top talent team here putting this together. And tying it all together, we're using a lot of the technology that Blockstream has been building. You could say we're commercializing a lot of the things. So it's running on a dual token model. There is a security token for raising capital, and there is a utility token that is replacing the in-game currency. So like World of Warcraft Gold, it's replaced with a crypto asset that is portable for the players. So for the security token side, we've already raised $3.1 million, and we're going out to raise another $12 million. $8 million is slated for the EU and $4 million for the US. So this is taking advantage of that change in the regulatory landscape that I talked about, where it's much easier and much more efficient to go the regulated route now. And by having this dual token model, we're not mixing it up. We're not selling a token that we say is utility, but could be construed to be a security down the road. It's just much more clean and well-defined.
So let me ask you this. I think I know the answer. Why not use liquid Satoshis in the game? Is it because you want to create your own currency and then you guys get to basically pre-mine or have a portion of that as a kicker in addition to the funds that you're raising on the utility side? I'm assuming that's the answer.
We could use like Satoshis, like a lot of the Lightning games, and you know, reward players that way. But I think it takes away from immersion. So for MMO games of this genre, part of it's role-playing. You want to be immersed in the universe, immersed in the story, in the lore. And if you're playing this game and earning sats, which we could do, we could sell advertisements and then get money from sponsors and then distribute in sats. But then I think that takes away from the whole experience. The other part is that we want to run this sort of as an experiment to see what happens, because typically MMO games don't embrace any kind of portability for their players. They don't want you to take anything out of the game. They want you to buy a premium currency and it's locked up forever. So my theory is that the freest money will win. That's why Bitcoin will win. And I believe the freest game that is open to secondary markets and open to letting players basically do more and trade freely will win too.
So you get the tokens inside the game and you want to bring them out of the game. You can then swap them into Satoshis, liquid Satoshis at that point?
Yeah. So this could be listed on an exchange because it's just a liquid asset like USDT or LCAD or anything. Or the players can trade peer-to-peer because it's all in the liquid network. It's freely movable and you have the benefit of confidentiality too. You don't really need it for a game currency, but I think it is good because you don't want people watching what you're doing. And the interesting thing here is the application to gaming. So in a lot of MMO games, like we hear about crypto hacks all the time, but there's also hacks in MMO games too, where someone will join a guild and they infiltrate the guild and they steal money from the guild. This has happened a few times in EVE Online. But with a crypto asset, you could actually create a multisig that would prevent someone from stealing it. The reason this happens in games now is because it's bound to an account, and you generally give access to that account to somebody. That's how you manage the guild treasury. But this brings a little bit of the crypto security element to the game. And you could even put this on a hardware wallet, like a Trezor or Ledger or Cold Card down the road too.
I mean, I'm just listening to this and my mind is just exploding. Like, I just can't even believe this is real. For somebody who's hearing this and they heard you say that you're going to be issuing security tokens which is a fundraising round, right? To build this game out with all the engineers that you said you had. If a person wants to buy one of these security tokens, how is this a publicly issued like IPO for people to buy this? And if it is, how would they buy it?
So we're filing for a Reg A offering in the US with the SEC. So once that is done, it's effectively an IPO. They call a Reg A Plus a mini IPO. And it's really cool because then your tokens are freely tradable and there's no need for accredited investors. In the EU, we're working with Stalker. They're a platform, sort of like Kickstarter, but they support securities. So you can just go to stalker.io, register, and you can invest if you're a non-US resident. And if you're in the US, you can contact us directly. We can do a SAF before it's open. But once the filing is done and we're Reg A approved, then you'll be able to buy on an exchange like INX or T0 or any other security token exchange.
Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on the next podcast episode and new investing resources.
What are your takeaways and thoughts on this discussion? Let us know in the comments section below.